Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much. I always say that, but thank you guys so much for tuning into my channel for today. For today's video, we're going to just be having a little chit chat session where I talk to you guys all about post-grad life and what I've been learning in this season of my life and just other nuggets here and there. One thing that I've been learning so far is to stay busy. I know one of the enemy's tactics is to really get you in a place where you're isolated and you're bored and you don't have anything to do and you're discouraged and you're looking around at everyone else fulfill the plans that the Lord has for them, and he is going to have you thinking that something is wrong with you, that you really need to like go jump off a cliff or something. And so I really want to encourage you guys to stay busy. So when I first graduated, of course, I didn't just start working like the next week. I had a month where I really just relaxed and took everything in. And during that month, I really kept myself engaged. And so I would go to Bible study every week. I would, what would I do? I would go running, like I would work out. I would cook different things. I would just do things to really keep myself busy, because I just knew that the second that I put myself in isolation, I was going to be depressed. Y'all, post-grad depression is real, okay? Like, I've heard this before. I've heard people talk about this before. It is real, but by God's grace, that's not my portion, and I don't pray for it for anyone else. But yeah, it's definitely a real thing. And so, one, stay busy. Find something to do. Join a life group. Join a fellowship close by. Join a workout session, training group, something like that. Number two, stay driven. And this goes hand in hand with staying busy. Stay driven. You're not going to have anybody on top of your back telling you what to do. And it's kind of like college, because in college you really didn't have anyone telling you what to do. But this is really like the real world, okay? You're not going to have anyone on top of you reminding you to apply for jobs. You're not going to have anyone on top of you reminding you to update your resume, update your cover letter, reach out to people, network, go work out, make sure you're still eating, make sure you're not like overeating, make sure, you know what I mean? You're not gonna have someone on top of you. So really just staying driven and really being intentional, taking the initiative as well. Like I say, you're not gonna have somebody on top of you telling you to do things. So if you're the type of person who constantly needs reminders, who constantly needs somebody to hold them accountable, I would really say get on top of it as soon as possible. Don't wait until you're like 6 months post-grad and you're just now realizing that, hey, I graduated. Like, why didn't y'all wake me up? Like, I graduated. Like, no, you don't want to be that person. And so if you know that you're somebody who really struggles with being consistent, being driven, taking the initiative to do things, I would encourage you to reach out to somebody. Maybe find a mentor. Find somebody that is going to hold you accountable. Number three, stay in fellowship with the Lord, okay? Stay in fellowship with the Lord. That is where, and that should have just been the first thing, but that is where direction is going to be birthed out of, right? Psalm 119 verse 105 says what? It says that your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Maybe you had a desire to do engineering while you were an undergrad, and you were just constantly like on the go, like your mind was just like engineering, like a robot almost. And now that you've graduated, you've kind of settled down, and now you are beginning to see that this desire isn't there as it was when I was an undergrad. And so now it's time for you to now unwind and really sit back and think about this whole engineering of a thing, and really begin to fellowship with the Lord, because in him desires are birthed, right? In him some desires may be removed. So really getting in the word of God and really seeking the face of the Lord to see what it is he's going to have you do. That desire for engineering may still be there. It may go. Who knows? But as you fellowship with the Lord, his word is literally going to be a lamp unto your feet. And so just vision a dark place, a dark path. You're in the woods at night. Hopefully you aren't, but you're in the woods at night. The word of the Lord is literally going to be like a lamp, right? As you're walking down that dark path of life, that dark path of post-grad life, his word is literally going to be the light that's going to give you direction. The Bible says in Isaiah 30 verses 21 that as you walk, there is going to be a voice behind you telling you whether you should go to the left or to the right. And so ultimately, you need to stay in fellowship with the Lord. And lastly, number four, I encourage you to study your craft, okay? I understand that in undergrad, you may have a lot of things that you are working on, right? That you are working towards. Number one, graduation. Hello, you need to first graduate before you can figure out what you want to do with your life next. And you may also be involved in other different things like different clubs and different honor societies and different groups or whatever. You may not have the time to really sit down and study your craft. For those who've had that time, praise God. I praise God for your life, but some people just didn't have that time. The best thing for you to do now that you've graduated from school, you don't have any obligation, you don't have an exam, right, coming up, you don't have something that you need to submit on Blackboard that is due at 11:59 that you're still working on at 11:57, hello. You don't have all of those different obligations and different things that are like pulling and fighting for your attention. Rather, you're in a place now where you can move at your own pace. And I say that very lightly, because if you move at your own pace too much, you may just be left behind because you're moving too sluggishly and opportunities are coming and going. And so what I mean by studying your craft and really perfecting your craft is, okay, what is it that I want to do? I'm saying that I want to go to PT school, physical therapy, right? I want to go to physical therapy school. What am I doing to now study that craft? Am I researching the best PT schools in my area? Am I researching PT scholarships? What am I doing in my now? What am I doing at home when everyone else is at work and at school? What am I doing? Because you need to have something to work with. You know what I mean? That's something that the Lord has really been teaching me as well, is that, Cynthia, like, yes, you have all these great ideas and plans and stuff in your mind. Yes, I can do exceedingly abundantly above all that I can ask or think, but you also need to do something. You also need to have something to bring to the table. Nehemiah, right? He had a desire to want to see his city turn back to the Lord and to really build his city back up. And so he prayed and fasted and mourned on behalf of his city, and he went out. The Bible says that he didn't tell anyone what the Lord had placed in his heart to do, right? He didn't tell anyone. He just got up, him, and it was even him and a horse, right, that went and began to camp out and go to this place so that they can begin to rebuild the city and rebuild the wall. And so you have to first purpose in your heart that this is something that you want to do. At least have something, you know, write the vision down and make it plain, something tangible that you can now say, Lord, this is what I want. Lord, please bless this. I'm just going to leave that there. I'm going to allow that to sink in. I want you guys to drop down some things that you've been learning in this season of your life. You know, what have you been learning? What has the Lord been teaching you about? And I really just want to know. Let's chit chat. So thank you guys so much for tuning into my video for today, and until next time.